And we take a look at the tail of the tape, Finland versus Ireland in this one, and a substantial reach advantage for the Ireland native Shauna Mama B. Bannon, who's 4-0 and 1-0 in her Invicta career. And again, you see the odds from BetMGM. Bannon a heavy favorite in this one.
And now here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Three rounds of action this scheduled in the strawweight division. Introducing to you first, fighting out of the blue corner. She is a kickboxer standing 5 feet, 5 inches tall. Weighing in officially 115 and 3/4 pounds. In four fights, her record stands perfect with 4 victories and no defeats. Here's the undefeated strawweight from Dublin, Ireland, Mama B, Shauna Bannon! And across the cage, her opponent fighting out of the red corner at 5 feet, 4 inches tall. This mixed martial artist also weighed in 115 and 3/4 pounds. In 10 fights, her record stands at 6 victories with 4 defeats. Fighting out of Turku, Finland, here is Mina Brutsku Grusander. And your referee in charge is Joel Ojeda.
Could Shauna Bannon come out in anything other than all green for this fight? Of course not. She's dressed in the green. Grusander is dressed in the black. And away we go in the strawweight division.
This will be Grusander's first fight at strawweight. She's moving up from atomweight, where she vied for the title here twice. Unsuccessful bids against Jinyu Fry, but a lot of time in this Invicta cage. She's got a lot of experience in here.
She also has a massive height and reach disadvantage here, Megan.
She does, but she has a lot of experience as well. You know, having a height and reach advantage isn't everything. Unfortunately, otherwise I would be undefeated. But she needs to be able to utilize her skills and her speed to be able to close that range and keep the range where she wants this fight to be.
She's definitely been using some of that reach. We saw some lovely little double round kicks off her front leg to the face of Grusander.
And that's that Taekwondo background that Mama B brings to the cage, too. She's very tricky with those kicks.
Good liver shot there.
Followed the kick with a 1-2.
Well, Grusander has a very high guard, so a lot of those strikes might not necessarily get through, but Grusander doing a good job of capitalizing off of that slip from Bannon, but Bannon is very good on the ground as well, as we've seen in her last fight, her transitions and her sweeps, very high level.
When we talk about Mama B, we shouldn't leave out the fact that Grusander actually has two little ones at home herself, and actually I caught up with her today, and her daughter was making some kind of bracelet for, she said, was her best friend, and actually slipped it under her water bottle. She found it on the plane here and said, "Mommy, this is for you, for luck. You're going to win." So she says, I have that bracelet with me. My kids are with me in this fight, if not physically.
Well, and the perspective that both fighters shared about being mothers, you know, Mama B. Bannon, quick to point out, she hasn't lost since her baby was born. And she says it's just given her a clarity of purpose in every way. Every day she goes into training, why she's doing what she's doing. You saw her get that win against Vera. That was the first thing she wanted to say when she was in the cage. After a few F-bombs and other colorful language that we liked.
Always entertaining the Irish.
Yeah, God bless the Irish. Beautiful speech. And we saw some nice transitions there on the ground. Grusander looking to pass her guard, but they're ultimately back up on their feet.
Take the Aloy.
When we talk about reach, reach also plays a big factor on the ground, the length of leg, the length of arm. It just depends on using it differently. Beautiful high kick there from the Irish native.
This is our day. Fakes, Charlotte. Yes. Fakes.
Another big kick And Mama B.
And as you find, every time Bannon switches to southpaw, she's looking for that liver kick. She's looking for that head kick from the open stance, and it's landing every single time. She's playing a much more patient game this fight around than we've seen in her first fight here under the Invicta banner. And you know, she's looking very good right now, but Gruzander is continuing to walk forward. She's not allowing Bannon to really solidify that range that she wants.
Gruzander's very tight on the inside with her strikes and her counters. Ooh, head and arm choke attempt there, standing head and arm choke by Bannon there. Gruzander clenched up, trying to keep her pinned on the fence and drag her to the mat.
Just looking for that outside leg reap.
Less than a minute to go in round number one.
Bannon's got those underhooks there, so beautiful job creating space, creating distance again. Look for this body kick.
Yeah, you call it. I mean, it's right there, that liver kick, too. Is.
She wasn't listening, Megan. Thirty seconds left in round number one.
And it's very hard to find your counter strikes against somebody who uses. Oh, lovely! Gruzander holds onto that leg, but it hit hard.
Now some ground and pound for Mama B. Bannon in the final seconds of round number one.
What a statement at the end of this round.
Mama B. Bannon closing out round number one, Megan Anderson.
Oh my goodness. And she's been setting up that head kick all fight. Every time she switches to southpaw, she's going to the body, going to the body, going to the body. And that it's going to pay dividends as the fight goes on, because Gruzander's going to drop her arms to defend that, which will set up that head kick. But, you know, Gruzander did a really good job of capitalizing off of that slip there. From Bannon, but this is the head kick right here. Beautiful right there, but the clean one, you know, was set up off of that body kick right here. Strong body kick, and that one hurt Gruzander. You see that left hand drop a little bit? Beautiful statement to the end of the first round for Bannon.
Round number one in the books between Gruzander and Bannon. Shauna Mama B. Bannon closing out round number one on the front foot, and here we go, round number two. Those kicks from Mama B. Bannon, Jules, in round number one were the difference, were they not?
Absolutely the difference, and the way she set them up, like Megan said, attack the liver, bring that high guard down and find your opening. She's also attacking the inside leg quite well. You want to keep somebody guessing as to where you're going to go. And it's not like she can't, you know, use her hands either. She's got some hard punches. Now we see Gruzander tied up on her back, looking to drag her to the ground.
Bannon doing a really good job, though, of making her way to the cage, using that as a post to help her keep her feet underneath her and not allow Gruzander to push her to the ground. But very smart move by Bannon there. Gruzander really needs to take control here of this fight and really make a statement in the second round after the first round.
And she had a very nice little brace on the face, elbow, but Bannon, works very well in her favor, she can read the second shot coming. She saw that set up again and was able to deflect. Oh, there it is again, that little elbow on the inside, not the most damaging if it's on the jaw. A power elbow though, ouch. Now she's complaining to the ref about something, but I don't know what. Okay, just a little bit of an adjustment there. I don't recommend people stop unless there's an actual lull to do that kind of adjustment and just keep fighting through. She's tied up on the arm now of Gruzander, like a standing crucifix position almost.
Bannon doing a really good job of using her hips to force the neck crank on Gruzander as she's looking to figure for that far arm. And end up right into mount. Oh my goodness, beautiful.
And it is very hard to mount the fin. She's very good at keeping a hook in at all times and keeping things in a half guard or guard position.
She's already got that butterfly guard hook in there, Julie.
Mm-hmm. Attempted an armbar there from Grusander, but Bannon pulls out of it wisely. And you can see now Grusander's looking for a way to sweep. Just absolutely trapping her own body under Grusander when she's trying to hook her with her arm.
Gonna coach Patty Holohan right there in her corner, just giving her sage advice. It's just, and it's the control, it's the patience, because this is a very technical position that if she makes the wrong move, she can get submitted.
Yeah, Grusander's looking, well, not there anymore. Ooh, nice little backhand there, but Grusander was looking to extend that knee and find a sweep. Now she's still attacking the legs, but Bannon's very smart. She's listening to her coach. I love when you're in the corner of your own coach and it's a combat conversation. It's just, you know exactly what she's doing. Now she's looking for the head and arm choke, Bannon.
Bannon showed her prowess on her feet with the kicks in round number one, but she's showing the grappling skills now here in round number two.
And doing one of my favorite things that fighters do, and using their head as a weapon, not a headbutt, but as a post and a position to grind.
Frame and elbow. Left hands, keep there in the hill of the left hands, keep scoring.
Using those braids as a weapon, right?
I love it. I love it. Use everything you have within, you know, legal limits. But it's also just, you can post from there and create leverage. And you can hear Bannon's coach calling for her to post an elbow at times. Grusander trying to control the bicep there.
It's also uncomfortable, mm-hmm. like having someone's forehead in your jaw and forcing it at an unnatural angle is 10 out of 10 would not recommend.
Keep your right leg back.
Some beautiful short elbows there by Bannon.
Cross your legs,
and you can see, you know, Bannon's corner's calling for her to have a more structured half guard position to throw those elbows. But again, Grusander's very good at digging those butterfly hooks and extending and always keeping her feet, keeping you guessing. Now, I mean, she's not in a great position, Grusander. There's a sweep. I don't think she's going to get it unless Bannon switches her hips too far.
50 seconds here.
But threatening that does keep her from posting and punch, or excuse me, elbowing as hard.
Let's get the knee to the mat. Push the knee to the mat, Charlotte. Push the knee to the mat, yes. Drag your knee through.
I think one of those elbows did some damage right under the right eye of Grusander.
Oh, yeah.
You see some swelling there.
You can see it. You can see Bannon targeting it, too.
Yeah, there you get a good look at it right there.
Oh, yeah, we're getting a big mouse right there.
Be careful here. Elbows.
And now we're coming to the final seconds of round number two. And you see that damage right there.
And one of the reasons the ref is stopping it, there were strikes to the back of the head, I believe, by Bannon. Now, I don't know that that was super, super deliberate. She was rallying strikes off, and Grusander was turning her head. But we'll see. You know, the ref did call and separate them there.
You can see that damage under that right eye really swelling up. Final seconds.
Bannon's, she's coming in hard. She didn't like being pulled up from that position where she was causing damage. Looking for a spin kick. Oh, nice.
Last second kick there from Mama B. Bannon. Joel Ojeda, to the referee, had to stop the fight. He very in there for a second. But we get to round number three. And Mama B. Bannon has been inflicting some damage, Megan.
She has. But these short elbows from Grusander, while they're not super damaging, they are uncomfortable and they add up over time. But this whole entire round, it was the narrative of Bannon and her control on the ground and the ground to pound. The patience, the positional maturity and not making those little positional mistakes that could either get her sweeped or get her submitted. You know, unfortunate happenstance at the end of that round that stood them back up, but the entire round was definitely the Mama B show.
Get up close and personal with some of your favorite bands every Wednesday night with Live from the Artist Den.
Check out Cage the Elephant, Mumford & Sons, and Elvis Costello, and many more. Tune in every Wednesday night at 8 p.m. Eastern. On to round number three, strawweight bout between Mina Grusander out of Finland and Shauna Mama B. Bannon out of Ireland.
That is the Irish left leg from hell. She's able to do so much with it. Those side kicks, those round kicks, and just the way she used it to set up other things.
And that's what's so beautiful about her taekwondo background is she's so dangerous from both stances. From the orthodox stance, she's looking for those side kicks, looking for those teeps from the lead leg. But when she switches to southpaw, it's the liver kick from the left leg, the head kick, and just the diversity in the range is so impressive.
A lot of things to consider if you're Grusander.
Yeah, a lot of different looks that you can't really prepare for, because Bannon does a really good job of setting them up in a way that you don't know which one is coming.
We saw from the judges' scorecard Bannon on top, winning the first two rounds on all three of the judges' cards.
And you can kind of read sometimes when she wants to throw that left head kick, when she switches to that lefty stance, but it's not always there because she can fire it up her front leg just as fast and just as hard. More urgency from the Finn coming in. She knows she needs to close distance, do some damage, and get to a finish here.
Elbow from Grusander.
Yes.
Bannon able to separate. Right back to those kicks as soon as she gets that separation.
I have so much respect for people who can maintain taekwondo kicks in an MMA setting. I used to get my butt beat by Muay Thai fighters when I tried to do taekwondo, but she's able to incorporate that so well. I love how much this sport has evolved.
Uppercut from Bannon.
Oh,
left
nice
hand from Grusander.
Hands up.
Oh, lovely.
Looking to take the back. Grusander tries to roll for a knee bar.
Yeah, and that knee bar roll, it sets up a nice scramble for her, but it does put her in a dangerous position if she doesn't finish it. The hip is somewhat trapped there. She's attacking the foot now. The knee is extended.
I just pulled my hamstring watching this, by the way. Bannon with just under halfway left in round number three.
But the way Bannon is hitting and where she's hitting, that's the liver. That's not a great place to be hit. She doesn't have the leverage for the super hard strike, but she's staying very, very calm. The leg that is being extended is the one she did all the damage with. So she's got some flexibility there in that leg and probably is content to let it stretch a bit.
And just hammered away at the liver, Bannon.
And Grusander's got to roll to get any kind of finish on a leg lock there.
She's got a bit of a bend in that knee, so the knee bar isn't completely dead. Now it's straightened out again. She's so flexible.
Yeah.
That's why I said I pulled a hamstring watching it.
Makes me think I gotta start doing yoga again.
Bannon does do yoga. She does incorporate that into her training and preparation. So, I mean, this could be working out for her right now.
And she's having a conversation right in front of her corner with her corner.
She's able to hook that outside leg.
Great shot right there.
Leverage.
Oh, beautiful, beautiful punch there. Yeah, just stay patient. When her leg was threatened, use the leverage and experience and flexibility she had, and now she's on top and doing damage.
You can see the encouragement coming from the corner of Mama B. Bannon. She's trying to close out this third and final round.
Shots on it. She's only covering. Shots on it.
And when you're up on the scorecards like this, some people might be content to rest a bit, but
absolutely
Bannon wants a finish. Oh, watching for the armbar there. Very smartly read that attempt from Grusander, and now she's on her feet. She wants a finish, though. I know she does.
She's calling Grusander back up to her feet now, but only 10 seconds left in this bout.
Oh, like
she
a tornado
a
kick
finish.
Knee. Yeah.
Mama B. Bennett. One of a couple fighters carrying the flag for Ireland here tonight at IFC 52, Shauna Mama B. Bannon. It's been all smiles for her, Megan.
It really was, and she looked absolutely impressive tonight. From the first round to the last round, she elevated, she stepped up. The first round, it was very much a picture of the left kick from Southpaw. She set it up with the body kick. She set it up for the head kicks. And it was the left body kick from Southpaw that was the narrative of round number one. And as we went to the second round, it was the ground game of Bannon that showcased her well-roundedness. And she's not just a striker. She's not just a Taekwondo girl. And she showcased the maturation of her journey as a mixed martial arts, the ground control, the patience, the diversity, and the range that she is able to bring to the cage was so incredibly impressive tonight, Julie.
It was, and you know, something she's told us coming into this fight week was that I'm gonna win tonight, and I want Danny to win tonight, and I want to fight Irish against Irish. I want Invicta in Dublin. That's where I want our fight to take place for the strawweight title. And, you know, with this victory tonight, she's made a very good argument for herself to tie or to vie for a championship.
Shauna Mama B. Bannon believes that she's just gone to 2-0 in her Invicta career. Let's find out officially as we send it in to Joe Martinez.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards, and all three have it 30-27 for your winner by unanimous decision. She is still undefeated, Mama B, Shauna Bannon.
She's all smiles. She's landing back in Ireland on St. Patrick's Day, victorious here today. She's giving Allie Trost-Martin a hug, and now she's probably going to give us some good sound bites, too. Let's go to Allie.
Shauna, the St. Patrick's Day festivities starting a bit early here in Denver, Colorado, but no luck needed in that one. A dominant performance, and you said you need a big one if you wanted to be able to feel confident and calling for the title. How would you grade your performance in the cage tonight?
Yeah, I was really happy. I think I showed all aspects of my game. Thank fuck for kickboxing all them years, because flexibility on my knee bar saved me. But yeah, happy Paddy's Day, everyone! Woo!
How were you able to exploit your opponent's weaknesses in the cage and use all ranges of your MMA talents?
Me and my coach had a perfect game plan. Down to him, I just listen to him and do what he says, and it pays off. I'm 5-0 now, still undefeated. I come from a family of fighters. My sister still fights for Ireland in kickboxing. My dad fought for Ireland in kickboxing. My granddad fought in the Irish Army. I'm coming from a fighting family, and I think tonight I've proved that I'm eligible for a title shot next. Shannon, where is she? I don't know where she is, but I'm next for that title. Best of luck to the two ladies tonight. The two of them are deadly, but I'm up next.
All right, Shannon, congratulations. Shauna, Mama B, let's hear it one more time.
One more. It's Mother's Day on Sunday in Ireland, so I just want to say a shout out to all the mamas, because it's not easy being a mom, especially the ones that are doing it alone. So happy Mother's Day to everyone, especially my mom, who has done so much for me in this camp. She's literally stayed in my house every night to look after Jace while he's sleeping, while I was in the altitude tent. So thank you so much, mom.
For all the mamas, congratulations.